The Blücher sank during the Operation Weserübung, the German occupation of Norway and Denmark in 1940. During the operation, the German Navy sent out almost all of their ships to conquer Norwegian ports. Blücher was one of the ships that was sent to occupy Oslo, the capital of Norway. The fleet that was heading into the Oslo fjord consisted of the heavy cruiser Blücher, the heavy cruiser Lützow, the light cruiser Emden, two torpedo boats, and a couple of smaller vessels. In addition to their normal crews, the ships had infantry troops and their equipment on board. The entrance to the Oslo fjord was protected by two islands. Each of them had a small fortification on them that were equipped with 15-centimeter guns. The biggest fortress in the fjord was Oscarsborg Fortress. The fortress was equipped with 28-centimeter guns and a torpedo battery. The fleet arrived in the fjord half an hour before midnight. The German government was hoping that Norway would accept the coming occupation with little or no resistance. The fortresses were supposed to be taken by surprise rather than by force. After a patrol boat had spotted the ships, the Norwegians ordered to extinguish all navigation lights. The small fleet passed the two island fortresses at 18 knots speed. Nevertheless, they were spotted by the Norwegian gunners, who fired at the leading Blücher. But the German vessels all managed to pass the Norwegian guns undamaged. It was obvious that the Norwegians were not interested in a friendly occupation. The captain of Blücher urged the commanding admiral to increase their speed, so they would pass the Oscarsborg fortress when it was still dark, and the garrison would potentially be unprepared. But Admiral Kummetz decided to follow his orders to pass the fortress at 5 o'clock in the morning. It was starting to get light when they reached the Dröbak Sound. Blücher, the flagship, was in the lead, followed by Lützow and Emden. They were hoping to pass the sound unchallenged. The commander of Oscarsborg Fortress had not been informed about the German invasion. He had no information about the nationality of the ships, nor their intentions. But given the fact that they had forced their way into the fjord, he had to consider them to be enemy. So he decided to attack. He ordered to fire his 28 guns at Blücher. The effects were disastrous for the German ship. The first shot hit the ship above the bridge and killed the commander of the anti-aircraft guns. The second shot set the aircraft hangar on fire. When Blücher was moving out of range, the Norwegian guns focused their fire on Lützow. They hit the forward gun turret and managed to disable two of its 28-centimeter guns. The captain of Lützow decided to turn his ship out of the fire. Meanwhile, Blücher came into range of the torpedo battery. The battery fired two torpedoes. Both of them were direct hits and destroyed the turbine and boiler rooms of the cruiser. The raging fire on board of the ship started to ignite the ammunition and petrol reserves of the landing troops. The ship had lost speed and drifted further into the fjord. When it became obvious that he could not save his sinking ship, the captain ordered to evacuate the vessel. As there was only one undamaged lifeboat left, most of the men had to jump into the freezing water that was partly covered in burning oil. Depending on the source, between 250 and 1,000 men were lost in the sinking.